Good morning, children. Welcome to the online class. How are you, children? Children, in today's class, we are going to start our new lesson. The second lesson, that is knowing about plants. Knowing about plants. What do you know about plants, children? First of all, I want to pose a question for you. What do you know about plants? Can we survive without plant, children? Can we survive without plant? No, children. See, children, plants are primary producers. Plants are primary producers. Means which produce. They are producers. Okay, children, what they are going to produce? They can produce a number of a wide variety of foods and objects. What objects, sir? Foods we know, sir. Fruits, vegetables and dried fruits. We are all getting from these plants, no, sir. We want to know how objects are produced. A tree. We can use the wood of a tree to make number of different objects. Yes or no, children? And from the tree or from the plant, we are getting cotton. That cotton is used to weave handlooms. Yes or no, children? So we are getting a wide variety from paper which you are using to write in. That also coming from the plants only, no, children. So plants are the primary producers. If I ask you one question, what do you know about plants? Plants are primary producers. And we cannot survive without plants, children. Because by the concept of process of photosynthesis, plants synthesize or prepare their own food. Okay, children, their own food. And that food we are consuming. Understand, children? Plants prepare their own food by using the photosynthesis concept. That is C6H12O6 plus 6CO2 and 6H2O. All these, children, in the presence of sunlight. Okay, children, you come to know the formula of photosynthesis in this class only. In this class means in this topic, in this lesson. Understand, children? In the next further class, you may know the formula of photosynthesis. First of all, we know deeply what about a plant. Knowing about plants, no, we need to know about them very clearly. First of all, children, if we take a human body structure, it is compacted with a number of parts: hands, legs, heads, head and shoulder, and in number of other such small things also there, children. Organs, we call them as organs. There are number of organs in our body. Those are heart, kidneys, liver, and systems like digestive system, reproductive system, urinary system. Like that, there are number of systems and number of body organ parts in our body. Yes or no? Like that, there is a structure in the plants too. Okay, children, we know them clearly, children. First of all, the first task before going into the lesson only, you should know and you should do this activity, children. This is nothing but you use it to collect. You collect some small plants near your surrounding house. You collect 4 or 5, children, and you bring to the home and check whether the small plant have roots or not, whether the small plant have stem or not, whether the small plant has branches or not, whether the small plant having flowers or not, or leaves are having or not. You check this, children, and you try to write in a book. As example I am giving, children, I am taking the plant Tridax. Tridax is the name of the plant, children. So here it is a root column, stem column, leaves and flowers. These 4 enough, children? Example I am giving, Triadax is the name of the plant, and you have to check it. Okay, if suppose you assume this as a plant, you need to check it whether it contains roots or not. Yeah, it contains roots. Yes. Next stem, this plant contains stems or not? Yeah, it contains stem. You keep writing yes. Leaves. Yes, children. Every plant almost have leaves. Okay, children. Yes. Flowers. Triadax has flowers, but some plants may have flowers or may not. No problem. You identify letter. Identification of this is the activity name called as identification. Identification. Identification of plant parts. Okay, children. You know identification. What is your identification? If I say means you remove the, you take out that Aadhaar card. This is my identity. I am the resident of India. You will show this. That is your identity. That is a unique identity. Along with that, you have PAN card, voter card, license. All these acts as a identification for us, which we are living in the society. But coming to the plants, we can also identify them whether what type of parts they consist. So you try to write the some plant names whether you collect from the surrounding areas. Whether it contains yes or not means no. That's all, children. We'll see the first main part of the plant, that is nothing but the root. So children, you should know that there are number of parts of a plant, children. The first part of the plant is root. 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 This is the starting part of a plant, children. This is the starting part of a plant. If there is no need, if there is not there this part, it cannot survive the entire plant, because the roots provides the total strength of the plant, children. It gives the water to the entire parts of the plant, and it supplies the supplements like minerals and whatever the nutrients are there in the soil, it gives to the other plant parts by using this root system. Understand, children? So this is the main part of a plant. And these roots are again classified as two types. Two root systems are there, children. The first root system is tap root system. Tap root system. The second one is fibrous root system. So children, I need to give the definition for the root. First of all, the underground part of main axis of the plant. The underground part of the main axis of the plant. This root is present on the above the surface or below the surface, children. Yes, children, you are correct. It is present in the underground, just below the surface, children. You cannot visualize it. If you take it and you can see the plant roots, or otherwise you cannot come to know whether it has roots or not. So it is again divided into two types of root systems. The first one is a tap root system, and the second one is a fibrous root system. So what is tap root system, sir? Tap root system is nothing but a root which arises as a single root, children. It arises like a single root. Okay, children. This is a tap root system. It arises as a single root, only one. Okay, children. And some other roots arises from this tap root. Some other roots arises from this tap root. These arising roots are called as lateral roots. Whatever the arising roots are there, they are called as lateral roots. The main the main root is called as taproot, and it goes down into the land. Okay, children, this is what we call as taproot, the single root which goes down into the soil, and some other roots which are arising from that main root is called as lateral roots. And the second kind of root is fibrous root. Fibrous root. So fibrous root is nothing but a cluster of roots is called as a fibrous root. Cluster means a combination of more roots is called as a cluster. Okay, children, this is the stem of the plant. From this stem the roots arises from this stem, children. So we call it as a cluster. Cluster means a group of roots. Okay, children. So children, whatever the roots are arising from this stem are of equal size. They are of equal size. Okay, children, they are of all of a equal size. So this is what we call as fibrous root system. Fibrous root system. So children, you know the definition of a root, the underground part of the main axis of a plant. And you should also know the functions. It provides water and nutrients and minerals which are there in the soil continuously to the plant parts, children. Understand, this is the main function of the root, children. It provides the water, nutrients and minerals to the plant parts. Different parts are there, no, children. So it provides continuously. So this is all about root, children. In our next class, we are going to discuss the second part of the plant, that is a stem. Okay, children. Thank you.